We're witnessing the rise of a completely new computing era. Within the next decade, a $1 trillion-plus data center business is poised for transformation, powered by what we refer to as extreme parallel computing, or as some prefer to call it, accelerated computing. While artificial intelligence is, of course, the primary accelerant, the effects ripple across the entire technology stack. I mean, to give you an idea of the scope of this transformation, in 2022, accelerated computing comprised about 10% of all data center spending. By 2030, it will account for almost 90%. And importantly, the overall data center market is expected to grow by 3.6x in that timeframe, according to theCUBE research estimates. Hello and welcome to our executive forum on AI infrastructure and innovation. Now, in this series, we're going to explore the architectural principles and operational strategies that drive successful AI initiatives. You're going to hear from industry leaders at Penguin Solutions on why some enterprises achieve AI breakthroughs while others struggle, and how to build environments that support both current and future workloads at peak performance. And we're going to reveal why traditional approaches often fall short, causing GPU clusters to operate at only about 50% of their potential. And we're going to show you how to construct scalable, efficient AI environments that accelerate results. So the first session we're going to do today is called The Race to AI Dominance, Rapidly Deploying and Optimizing AI Infrastructure. And it features Pete Manca, who's the president of Penguin Solutions. Pete will discuss how CEOs and CIOs can quickly adopt and institutionalize AI as a competitive advantage, striking the right balance between speed and stability to ensure operational efficiency and long-term flexibility. Now, let's welcome Pete into the program. He's the president of advanced computing at Penguin Solutions, and he's got extensive experience helping enterprises bridge the gap between traditional IT practices and the high-performance computing requirements of modern AI workloads. And today he's going to share strategies for deploying AI infrastructure rapidly and at scale without sacrificing resilience or future agility. Pete, welcome to theCUBE.
Thanks,
great
Dave.
To see you again. Appreciate you coming in.
Yeah, it's great to see you too.
So when you're out talking to customers, talking to organizations, what are you hearing from them? What are their biggest challenges? They're doing a lot of experimentation in the cloud, but they want to bring AI in-house. They want to build centers of excellence. They understand the importance, but they don't have the skills. What are they telling you?
Yeah, the market's moving incredibly fast, right? As you mentioned, it's growing exponentially. The enterprise customers we speak to know they have to get some kind of AI strategy in place, whether it for simple things like increased service offerings or more complex things like fraud detection and other use cases we hear out there, but they don't know how to get there, or they're not set up today in order to get there. Traditional infrastructures are very different than AI infrastructures. And so they have to rethink how they do IT. You can go to the cloud, you can do that, but a lot of enterprises aren't willing to take the massive amounts of data or the proprietary data that they have and put it in the cloud. And so the choices are really go to what we would call a tier two service provider, or you know, not a hyperscaler cloud, and leverage their capabilities, or build it in-house. Building in-house is probably the preferred way to go, but it means literally a soup to nuts transformation from data center build out, power, cooling, all the way through architecture of their system. So it's a very complex environment, and they look to partners like Penguin Solutions to help guide them through that as a trusted advisor. That's really what we do.
When I was prepping for this, I wrote down just some of the vectors and challenges. Data gravity, everybody wants to do on-prem AI, the cloud's expensive, they're uncertain about ROI, they got skills issues, they don't really necessarily know how to architect hybrid AI. So there's all these sort of things coming at IT professionals, and they don't want to just build a snowflake.
That's right.
Not, I mean, Snowflake, the database company. I mean,
right.
You know, a different
custom
solution, a custom
right.
solution. They've got to build stuff that's proven, not only proven, but then standardized so they can scale. So what strategies are customers employing to do that, and how are you helping?
Yeah. So first of all, it starts really all the way to the left side. It starts at the very beginning. And I mentioned data center earlier. It literally starts at the data center. If you look at today's data centers in enterprise technology or enterprise companies, they're not set up for this kind of infrastructure. And so we have to get involved very, very early on, help them through making decisions around where their data center is going to be, what kind of cooling will be in their data center. Is it liquid cooling? Is it direct to chip? Is it, you know, traditional air cooling? And you bring that all the way through design to the end. What we do at Penguin is we help them through all those decision points. And we offer them a choice. We offer a custom solution. You said Snowflake, but I'm going to use the word custom because I don't really think it's a Snowflake per se. There's so many choices between chip vendors. You want to be NVIDIA or AMD GPU house, storage. Is it parallel file system? Is it WEC or Avast or DDN? What kind of network? Is it InfiniBand or, you know, high bandwidth Ethernet? Mm-hmm. There's so many choices out there. And there's really a couple different ways you can go. You can build a custom solution for your, you know, for your use case. We'll help them through that. Or you can build an off-the-shelf solution where you leverage either NVIDIA technology like DGX, or you leverage one of our Origin AI reference architectures that allows a pre-configured architecture for a particular use case. And so we help guide them through that those decision points every step of the way.
You know, I love the name Penguin because I'm envisioning all these penguins on the iceberg. They all want to have on-prem AI and they're ready to dive in. And then that first one's going to go and it's like, then the competitive fire.
Well, that's exactly right.
You know, that's right. The banks all get this.
That's right.
And they talk to each other and they're like, whoa, if we get left behind, we're going to be in big trouble. And you mentioned all these different permutations, whether it's the networking, the file system, every part of the stack is being, you know, reformed, as we were saying up top. How do you ensure resilience in such an environment?
Yeah, that's a good question. That's really just a design principle. I mean, a lot of the technology, you can pick and choose depending upon your use case. The trick is designing it right up front. What you don't want to do is put these pieces together. And the difference between this and a typical IT environment is scale. And a typical IT environment might have 100, 1,000 servers. You know, you can manage that in-house with your IT staff. You spread that out to tens of thousands of GPUs for these large language training models with very sophisticated networking, direct-to-chip, things like NVLink and maybe optical or other types of technology that allow you to bypass the main core CPU and go right GPU to GPU. That gets really complex. And so, you know, we think you need to have a trusted advisor like Penguin to help you design those architectures and help you do it with resiliency and with quality so you can get the uptime. Like, you know, we see at some of our customers where we bring them from 50% uptime today on their GPU clusters to 95%. We've published many studies about that, and we've been very successful doing that, and it really comes down to proper design constraints right from the beginning.
What about utilizing GPU capacity? I mean, you referenced earlier, a lot of these customers that we talked to, they're having to, you know, re-architect their data center for liquid cooling. The CFOs are kind of gnashing their teeth. We know we have to do this, but we want to make sure that we have ROI. You know, you hear stories about, you know, GPU capacity being underutilized. And, you know, maybe the cloud guys are good at it. Maybe not. Maybe they're just throwing, you know, CapEx at the problem.
Right.
So, but enterprises, you know, they can't afford to do that. So what are some of the common pitfalls that you see for around GPU underutilization? And how are you helping customers address that?
Yeah, so that's a really broad question, right? It's an architectural discussion. You've got to get the data from the storage through the network into memory to feed these GPUs to keep them busy. Right, so right there, you've got an architectural problem that you're trying to solve around how do I get very sophisticated, high-speed, parallel file systems to feed these GPUs as much data as possible. And in some cases, in real time, it could be a batch or it could be a real-time processing engine. So you got to figure that out. Once you do that, then you got to make sure that you keep the GPUs up and running. They're a little bit finicky. It's new technology. You want to do things like predictive failure analysis. You want to understand if a GPU might fail, take it offline before it fails and replace it with a different one, right? So you can keep that cluster up and running at optimal performance. That takes a lot of skills and design capabilities that, you know, things like our intelligent compute environment software, Clusterware and AIM help our customers actually do that. Keep their GPUs up and running, keep them efficient and monitor them, make sure the health is good across the board.
You, in your career, have really had a big focus on simplifying things. Certainly simplifying cloud when it first came out, it was a complicated situation for a lot of people. You're back at it here in AI.
Yeah.
What are the similarities and what are the differences?
I think it's like all these, and you're right, I've been in this market, systems management, infrastructure management, simplifying operations for pretty much my entire career. And they all sort of look the same. Everything starts off very fast, rapid. We got to get to the end result before the next guy does. We got to solve this business problem faster than you know, our neighbor does. And that kind of rush adds complexity. And so the way to simplify it, I've always found in my career, is you create a software abstraction layer that hides the complexity of the underlying hardware. And you make it simple for the end user to manage the environment while you abstract away the complexities of the underlying hardware. And that's something that Clusterware does for our customers, is we try to abstract away all those complexities I just talked about around file systems and networking, and keep it simple and logical so that an end user can then manage the environment or plug in higher layers of the stack to, you know, to interface with the management of the infrastructure.
And it's not like you started, Penguin started, you know, on this just yesterday. I mean, you guys have been in this space for a long time. The market has come, it's interesting. You mentioned VAST and Weka and DDN. Yeah. Two are relatively new.
Right.
DDN's been around for a long time, but the market just sort of came to them. It's similar to Penguin, right? You're applying that expertise from your HPC days and then tuning it to enterprise AI.
Yeah, that's absolutely true. Penguin, I remember talking about Penguin, you know, 20 years ago when I was working at some of my other companies. Penguin's been around for a long time. A tremendous amount of expertise in large scale clusters. And sure, started off at HPC type clusters. AI wasn't in vogue back then. But that skill set's still important today, and it extends to the AI clusters because it's really about managing scale and managing complexity. So Penguin has decades of experience doing this. And like you mentioned with DDN, sure, the market came to us, right? AI took off like a lot. It happens a lot in this industry, right? Is some, you catch some trend and you find some expertise you have that might have been niche before, all of a sudden becomes incredibly powerful, incredibly important. And that's where we find Penguin today.
Yeah, you and I remember, you know, VMware started out doing workstation virtualization.
I sure do.
My last question for you is what advice would you have for organizations that they want to go fast, they want to accelerate their AI, but they want to have that operational flexibility and excellence going forward? So they're a little nervous right now. We don't want to rush in and then, you know, mortgage the future, but at the same time, they have to get there fast.
Right. Yeah, I mean, I'll give you one self-serving answer, which is call Penguin. You know, you want to talk to somebody who's been in this game for a while and who has been doing this for a long time. So you want to go to a trusted advisor, and that's what we are. But short of the commercial there, my advice would be to slow down just a bit and take your time and understand what kind of use case, what kind of outcome are you looking for, and what's the technology that's going to get you the best chance of getting that outcome. There's a lot of choices today. You can go with I like to use this analogy of the Apple iOS versus the Google Android, right? You can go with a DGX and an NVIDIA stack all the way up, kind of like Apple has done it, where they give you an entire stack and you can pick any flavor of ice cream as long as it's chocolate, right? Or you can go with the Google model where you can sort of mix and match and plug in best of breed. That's a fundamental choice right there that a customer has to make. I'd say step back, make that choice, what works best for you, and then work with partners like Penguin to help you implement that.
Yeah, a lot of complexity, especially if you go with the latter, because you're going to have different networks, as you say, and you know, different alternatives. And the former, it might limit some of your flexibility down the road. So and that's a real business case that you have to think about.
And there's a price trade-off as well.
Right.
That's right.
Pete, thank you. Appreciate your time.
My pleasure. It was great.
Okay, keep it right there. I'll be back shortly with Trey Layton, and we're going to dig into the new AI stack. Keep it right there.